Okay, there he's a lot more balanced with himself. He's ready to go left or right, whichever way I want. I like him to go to his left. See, there's a direction. Now I'm gonna set up a rhythm. See, and there he's being thoughtful. And there I have to kind of help him through because he was kind of lost there for a second. He wasn't quite sure. So he wanted me to give him some clarity. Here I like to tip his nose to me. And I like him go the other way. Now what I should have done with my left hand was grabbed a little bit more of the rope down to here. And that way I can give him a little bit easier direction. And again, it's for clarity. Now see there, he's not quite sure. But see his eye, it's a really nice eye. He's really trying hard. It's almost like I woke a little baby up and now he's 8 years old. There we go. And then forward. Now another thing that people don't do with babies too much is they keep trying to restrain them, so they hold them here with their nose next to us. But then when we do try to get them to go nose first, which is what we're doing when we're sitting on them, the horse says, that's not my point of reference. And then they panic and want us here. So a lot of the stuff that horses have issues with goes right back to when we train them in the first place and they have that alarm reaction and they just follow us around just to stay out of trouble. But what are they actually learning is not much because all they're trying to do is stay out of trouble. I like him shift his weight. But see, he lost momentum. If I can get it when the momentum's going, then it's gonna work for me rather than against me. But now I have to start all over. That's better. Okay, but see how it's still, I'm using a lot more energy than he is. So at the same time, I wouldn't exactly say, I'd say he's not quite sure, or he's expecting me to get after him, and I don't really want to do that. I just want him to follow the rhythm, focus rhythm and direction. There. See how easier he tipped into it? I had to kind of help him. Okay, I don't want to lose momentum. There we go. Now he almost wanted to set up a reaction there, but I backed off just enough when I saw him tipping into it. And then when I stopped, he stopped and see him checking in with me. And that's a lot better than him checking out. So let's see if I can get him to just shift his weight. So a big thing for him would be to learn how to shift his weight to the back end. Seeing he's lost because he just wants to go through with the front end and have the hind end kind of follow. But I want him to actually shift his weight. There. With the least amount of effort. And that's gonna wake up the backbone so he'll accept the saddle a lot more. Okay, there wasn't enough clarity for him. Let's do this a few more minutes. See, there's a direction, there's a rhythm. But he's gotta figure out which foot to move first. And he's also gotta try to figure out this rope, because it almost leads through me. So I'm gonna give him just a little bit more of a hint. There it is. And here I'm just kind of experimenting with something. Okay, that's better. What it was, the first time he did that, when I asked him with a certain rhythm, he slowed down just enough to tell me that he wasn't going to, but also he was trying to clarify the situation, see how consistent I am. But I didn't want to just get after him because then he would have kicked out. But I had to get something out of there where there's a flow to it. So it's real important for me to know when to back off and when to ask for a little bit more. And that's a personal issue between everybody and their own horse. You have to be aware of how much to give to the horse and when to back off. That's better. So what I'm trying to do is teach him that when he has that kind of energy, he's wasting a lot of it. See, right here, he's wasting energy rather than just going along with what I'm trying to accomplish here. So I look at it, if they're doing that, they're probably in survival mode. It's my first inclination, so it's up to me to set it up so they learn a little bit better. Okay, actually that's pretty nice. I'm gonna take advantage of this. See how he's keeping a certain distance from me, but he's still using the hind end? So I'm gonna take advantage of this situation. See, now we're kind of testing his patience and tolerance level and how much he can stay with me. Because the easiest thing for him to do is just run through here. But I like him to shift his weight and then find a straight line from his nose to his tail again. Another thing is, with horses, I'm always giving them a place to straighten up from their nose to their tail in a straight line. But see how crooked he is? And he's probably not quite sure how he can follow through, but I always want them to think that they're welcome to follow their own balance. And when I take them off balance, they're welcome to find their balance. I'm not gonna try to take that away from them. And that's pretty nice. I kind of had to help him there, but that's enough for today.
We're done anyway. Last 4 minutes of the tape. Anything you want to say to finish up? It was a great session.
Yeah, they'll see more in the next tape. And then we can build up on it. And then we can do little segments here and there. And more than anything, I just want to see where he's at and bring things up. And it's really amazing how some of these older horses, you know, it does say one thing about it. There's a certain way of, if you look at when babies have to learn, there's three stages: alarm, adaptation, then fatigue. And when they're first halted, broke, or weaned, that's where their alarm happens. And then they try to do the best they can through the saddling and everything else, the process. Then usually around 7 or 8, horses start falling apart and people can't figure out why. And then sure enough, he's at 8 years old, and that's where they adapt to the best they can if fatigue starts happening. And they get sluggish with their feet or their mind, or they're not quite sure. And then people think they're just, you know, because I hate to say, use that word, stubborn, you know that. But when you look at it from their point of view, they're just trying to survive. And this is a really hard world for them to be in, because our rhythm is so much different than theirs. And that's why I try to use this for a conductor, like a conductor's baton, where I just pick one of the legs and set up a rhythm. And without the rhythm though, without the direction added with the rhythm, then they're not going to be sure where to go. So if you look at it that kind of way, a pee off is just rhythm, but there's no direction. And then when we do want them to trot off, we just give them a direction and a place to go. And that's an easier way of looking at it.